Monte Carlo simulations are a popular risk assessment tool employed by traders. What exactly are they, and how do we make use of them? Let me explain.
Monte Carlo simulation is a computational technique that uses repeated random sampling to produce different test outcomes. In a trading context, it is most commonly used to randomize your backtest's trade sequence. Suppose you have performed a backtest and have a basket of 100 trades obtained over your backtest period. You begin randomly selecting trades from the basket, one at a time, until the basket is empty. You piece together each of the 100 trades in the order selected, producing a new equity curve. Now repeat this for hundreds or even thousands of times, and you have a whole bunch of new equity curves. This is what the characteristic straw broom charts represent, a collection of simulated equity curves. But what's the point of having so many equity curves? Every backtest, no matter how reliable, only represents a single run of your strategy over a certain historical period. Because of changing market conditions and the presence of random noise in every price dataset, your backtest statistics will never be exactly replicated in future. It's like flipping a fair coin 100 times and getting 53 heads. If you flip it another 100 times, you are unlikely to get exactly 53 heads again. By simulating multiple equity curves, Monte Carlo lets you determine the probabilities of obtaining different backtest outcomes. In particular, traders are interested in worst-case drawdowns. Since drawdown is affected by the sequence, not just the magnitude, of losing trades, these multiple equity curves can be used to produce a drawdown distribution that is more reliable than a single drawdown value. Before we go into more detail about these distributions, a brief explanation of confidence levels is required. Once you start rearranging the trade sequence of your 100 trade backtest, you could generate a total of 10 to the power of 157 different equity curves. That's an astronomical number that no computer can process in a reasonable time. You can achieve a compromise by simulating only a few thousand equity curves, and then using confidence levels to quantify the uncertainty caused by this simplification. Confidence levels are a concept borrowed from statistics and are used to measure the degree of uncertainty in a sampling method. A confidence level refers to the probability that the sampled results contain the true value of a certain parameter. When applied to Monte Carlo simulations, confidence levels will produce results like the one below. If you use a 95% confidence level, it means there is a 5% probability that the actual profit will be smaller than $513, and that the drawdown will be larger than $344. The 95% level is most commonly used in trading and the scientific literature. The higher the confidence level, the more the metrics will deteriorate, but the higher the probability that those metrics will encompass your future performance. This is how the aforementioned drawdown distribution is obtained. I'll take a sample strategy and run it through StrategyQuant's Monte Carlo simulator, producing 1,000 equity curves. The blue equity curve reflects the original backtest. Notice how the overall net profit remains the same for all the equity curves. This is a consequence of sampling trades without replacement. Returning to the basket of trades analogy, this means each trade cannot be selected more than once. But what if you return each trade to the basket after selecting it? This means each trade can be selected more than once, which is known as sampling with replacement. With sampling with replacement, chances are each equity curve will have a different endpoint, as shown here. Sampling with replacement is a good idea if you have a small backtest sample size, or you expect market conditions to change significantly in future. This particular backtest has 400 trades over 11 years, so I'll use sampling without replacement. Let's now make use of these results to gauge the strategy's robustness, which is a crucial measure of its insensitivity to market conditions. This is where the confidence levels come in. I like to look at the strategy's return over drawdown ratio at the 95% confidence level and compare it to that of the original backtest. For this strategy, the return over drawdown falls from 8.27 to 3.94, a 52% decrease. Ideally, I'd like to see a decrease of less than 50%, which is quite a stringent passing criteria. Note that profits decrease and drawdowns simultaneously increase as you progress through the confidence levels. Monte Carlo simulations can also produce a conservative estimate of your strategy's capital requirements. In this case, there is a $308 drawdown at the 95% confidence level. Assuming the historical backtest is representative of future results, there is only 5% probability that future drawdowns will exceed $308. Using this drawdown value, instead of the $147 from the original backtest, creates a buffer should market conditions deteriorate in future. so Monte Carlo simulations quickly simulate multiple backtest outcomes, giving you a conservative estimate of your strategy's robustness and capital requirements. Regardless of how many simulations you run, or which confidence level you select, remember that your results are estimations only. Future market conditions could well be worse than what was captured in your backtest. If you would like to try out StrategyQuant's Monte Carlo simulator, be sure to use the discount code in the description. Please support the channel by subscribing, and stay tuned for more content.